Which reminds me, you know, back in 1957, I was singing Aida with the ill-fated Suez Canal Opera Company. Egypt's President Nasser came backstage and said,
Madam Galupe-Borszkh, I want you to do your famous pianissimo.
Oh, my friend. You want to hear my pianissimo? Then you're going to have to stop at the racket out there. So Nasser halted the bombing in order to hear my pianissimo, thereby losing the war. I still get thank you notes from his. What a trip that was. You know, our plane was shot down. It was all a big misunderstanding. Egypt heard there was a Jewish star on the plane. So they fired. I was the sole survivor. I used my Aida wig as a flotation device. If you'd like to open this portion of the program with an aria from Maestro Puccini's first big hit, Manonesco. It was his great success with this bird, what inspired him to write all these really good operas afterwards. You know, in the past few years, we have lost so many great divas, including the beloved Renata Tobaldi, who was a great, great manonesco. I could not begin to sing this aria like Renata, and so instead, I am wearing my tribute. In this scene, I play Manon. Manon is 15, don't laugh. This is opera. And with opera, as with God, all things is possible. My dear friend Montserrat Caballé first sang Traviata in New York, and all the critics said, oh, I can't see her as consumptive, I can't see her as consumptive. Nonsense, I said, she's obviously consumed everything inside. Montserrat Caballé, what a beautiful name. Did you know that in Spanish the verb Caballé means to cancel? Manon is not a good girl. In fact, Manon makes Paris Hilton look like Mother Teresa. Her family decides to put her in a convent. And one day she meets the handsome young Chevrolet de Grier. And she falls in love in 16 bars. Sounds like me after the show. The young couple hijack the coach, which is why they call it Manon, let's go. And they run away to Paris, where they live blissfully but in poverty. They must have been spending dollars. Manon grows tired of starvation, and so she trades in the poorer Chevrolet for a more expensive model, the rich but old Gerante. Then Gerante discovers Manon entertaining the Chevrolet in her boudoir and hiding the family jewels under her cloak. He has her deported to the French province of Louisiana. This scene takes place on the vast desert just outside New Orleans. I don't write them, I just sing them. Manon is sola, perduta, abandonada, and very thirsty. But she has just enough saliva left to sing a big aria. In which she says, sola, perduta, abandonada, alone, lost, abandoned. The light is fading around me, and I'm starving to death. She laments the loss of her youth and her beauty. How many of you can relate to that? And suddenly she sees De Grier flashing before her eyes. No, she cries out, I don't want to die. But but she has to. It's act four.
Thank you. Yeah.